Hello friends, our today's topic is mandrel. Actually, mandrel is useful for the holding the workpiece inside the chuck, lathe chuck. Instead of chuck, direct holding the workpiece inside the chuck, we can use mandrels. The mandrels are specially useful for the hollow workpiece. First, I want to explain that what is the need of mandrel. Like if we are using a chuck, and we hold the workpiece, especially the hollow one, inside the chuck, and tool is applying the forces towards the job, means tool is pushing the jobs away from it, the job can be deflected from its center. But if we hold the mandrel in between the chuck and the tailstock or some dead center, and over there we hold the workpiece, whatever the forces tool will apply towards the job, we can say if tool push the job, it will remain its original position and it will rotate about the center only. Accordingly, we can enhance the accuracy of hollow job. The mandrels, like this is the mandrel, a complete shaft is the, and here is the workpiece. It holds the workpiece over the mandrel. In this, a shaft or spindle in the lathe to which work is fixed while being turned. If we have to turn the hollow job, we can place over the tapered mandrel. These are made of high carbon steel. Sometimes we can make the mandrels by mild steel just to reduce the cost. It can be fitted inside the hollow job, like in this. The job is fitted over the mandrel. There are different types of mandrels, like plain mandrel, strap mandrel, gag mandrel, collar mandrel, screwed mandrel, cone mandrel, expansion mandrel. Like this is the plain mandrel. This is very simple type of mandrel, generally available in all machine shops. It looks like a solid cylindrical tapered bar whose one side is large and other side is smaller in diameter. At the both end, a slot is provided so that it can be holded one side from the in the lathe dog, and other side is protected center hole for the dead center. Like this side there will be a tailstock, or this side we can hold in the chuck. This is the lathe dog. We have to mount the lathe dog with the mandrels, and on the mandrel we can place the workpiece. Lathe dog is required to hold the mandrel inside the chuck so that we can rotate it easily. Next type of mandrel is stepped mandrel. This type of mandrel can be used for several different diameter of jobs. Like there are different steps in this. We can hold different diameters in this, like this diameter, as well as this diameter. One job is this, other job will be this. And another job is this. We can hold different types of diameter in this. It is not just a hollow round bar. Some of the different diameter step collar are fitted with it so that a single mandrel can be used for holding various diameter. Means we can remove these hollow steps and we can replace these steps with the other steps, so that we can enhance the flexibility of the mandrel. Another one is the gag mandrel. It is some kind of stepped mandrel, and only difference is here a number of equivalent hollow jobs can be machined. Actually, these are the different types of jobs. If we have to machine, like we have to turn the job, and every job has to be the same diameter, then we can hold each and every job in a single mandrel, and we can machine all the jobs simultaneously. In this mandrel, a collar is fixed this side on one side, and the jaw are placed through another side, and then a nut is tightened. Nut and washer is used to tighten the jaw with the help of washer. Okay. This is the mandrel, which can enhance the productivity, because instead of machining one job, we are going to machine multiple jobs in real time. Another type of mandrel is collar mandrel. In this, there are two collars are fixed on the mandrel, collar 1 and collar 2, and job is placed over the collars only. Over the collars, because the main purpose of this type of collar mandrel is to reduce the weight of the mandrel. Like here, the diameter, taper diameter is just 0.8 to 1.5 mm, means this is very small, and job can be placed over the collar just to reduce the weight of the mandrel and to reduce the cost of the mandrel. If we use solid bar, then cost and weight of the bar is very much high. So instead of that, we can use this type of mandrel just to reduce the cost and the weight of the mandrel. Another type of mandrel is screwed mandrel. Instead of a plain mandrel, there some threads are formed over the periphery of the mandrel. Basically, this is the mandrel which can be useful to hold the jobs which having end side threads. One side there is a collar, and and the other side will be opened when internal thread workpiece can be entered. Means we have to screw the workpiece over the mandrel. Suppose this is the workpiece, and we have to screw the workpiece by rotating it and against the fixed collar. No need to use the dead center collar, because workpiece is already clamped due to the screw. Another type of mandrel is cone mandrel. It is the type mandrel which is suitable for any diameter for hollow job. Like there are some tapers. These tapers are useful so that we can hold a variety of jobs. Like suppose this is the cone, we can fit this diameter of the, and we can fit this diameter also. Means we can hold a variety of jobs. There is a fixed cone in this side and movable cone in this side. Just we have to move the cone. We have to place the work piece inside the in between two cones, and after that with the help of nut, we can hold and clamp the workpiece tightly, and we can start the operation. And the last type of mandrel is expansion mandrel. Basically, in this type, this is also useful to hold the variety of jobs. We can hold a number of different types of diameter in this job. In this, basically, there are two slots provided where two pins, we use two pins to hold the workpiece, and the third is useful. Here also we use pin with the help of two slot, one split up portion. After pushing the pins towards the sleeve, we have to push the pin towards the sleeve. Means this is similar to the chuck, just we can hold the workpiece over the sleeve. We have to push the workpiece towards the center with the help of the pins. That these are the different types of mandrels.